taking into account the pleasure principle of action, all behavior can be explained by the exercise of the will. The exception that proves the rule would be minds exercising the will over other consciousnesses, thereby negating the will of the recipient consciousness and, in turn, placing this mind outside the realm of action and not under the constructs of willful exercises, and therefore the pleasure principle. In the action by a will not at the hands of benevolent control to another will, places this will's inaction inside the constructs of an active consciousness, putting in motion actions and inactions to achieve a desired or perceptively valuable goal. Simply enough, the doer does in order to feel pleasure, while the non-doer does not in order to achieve the same end.